Hi, everybody. My name is Justin Payne, and I'm with the Food and Drug Administration Center for Food Safety and Applied Nutrition. And I'm coming to you right now from Bangkok, Thailand, where I'm in a two-week quarantine. Now, we've been using Galaxy in a system we call Galaxy Trakr, and I'd like to tell you about it. Now, of course, Genome Trakr is our multi-state, multi-nation network of foodborne whole genome sequencing. And associated with that effort, we set up Galaxy Trakr, a Galaxy instance that we use to support bioinformatics activity and foster collaboration and shared workflows, has come in training. Periodically, we run training programs to try to develop bioinformatics capacity among our state and federal lab partners. And over time, we found that the Galaxy platform is easy to use, but also we can do the training in a real production environment where students come sometimes with their own data already, and we can train them in workflows and analysis that they can do right away in the same environment where they did the training, and then they can take it back to their labs and be empowered right away to do real analysis to protect American food. A really important benefit for us is the collaboration the environment fosters. Researchers in our system exchange data easily, they can exchange workflows, they can collaborate on tools, they can even do a little bit of tech support for each other. And that really helps us take advantage of a small support staff and a small number of subject matter experts who can support, as a result, a large number of partners and users. Another big benefit is simply the cost savings. We have an on-premises HPC grid that we've used internally for some time now, which supports roughly the 30 to 40 users in SIFSAN doing whole genome biosurveillance. By comparison, we support thousands of users in the Galaxy Trakr platform now at a fraction of the cost of our on-premise HPC grid. And that's simply the result of the fact that the underlying AWS instances can be shut down when we're not using them. That grid can scale down to a dormant state when no one's doing analyses. The most unexpected benefit for us, though, was the use of Galaxy Trakr as a platform for software distribution. Recently, we've been targeting the Galaxy Trakr environment as the primary platform for tool release, and that has a lot of advantages. One is that we can install it once it becomes available for all users. The environment's very well controlled, it's well characterized, and so when we develop a tool for the environment, we install it once and we know it's going to work for the whole user base. That's anyone who's developed software knows what a benefit it is when you can install under controlled circumstances. Another benefit is that when we develop and install a tool into the Galaxy Trakr platform, it's immediately available to 1,000 users without any effort on their part. And they can immediately start working it into their own workflow. We receive immediate feedback about the use of the tool from our user base. I think a lot of developers are looking at Galaxy as a kind of secondary or even tertiary environment for their tools, targeting it probably after native OS packages, Conda and Bioconda. And looking at it in the opposite way has really been powerful for us. Now we target Galaxy Trakr as a primary platform for software development. We're making software architectural decisions and choices about what's going to work best in Galaxy when we develop tools. And that's really saving us a lot of time and effort down the road in terms of getting our software out there, getting feedback on it, supporting it, and developing and improving it over time. That's been a really unexpected benefit for the Galaxy platform for us. Anyway, these and a lot of the other benefits and our experiences developing the platform are described in our paper, which you can read in BMC Genomics. I'll put a link up so you can get it. If you're looking for a way to support a community of practice in bioinformatics, we've had really positive results with Galaxy and Galaxy Trakr, and I hope you'll check it out. It's free to use for anyone working in microbial bioinformatics and public health. Anyway, thanks for your time, and I hope you enjoy the rest of the conference, because I certainly am.